Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Lillian Space and today I'll be giving you guys 6 reasons why your hair is not growing. Let's dive into the video. So you might be wondering a lot of times like why your hair don't grow. Yes, you tend to believe that some people's hair grow and why some other people's hair don't grow. That is a very big lie. Everyone's hair grows. Your hair grows, but it depends on how you maintain it. Yes, the maintenance is the key to why your hair don't grow. Yes, other people's hair are growing while yours is not growing. Yes, I have been there before. I used to think that some people we are born naturally to have long hair, why some people don't. But let me tell you one thing. Every woman, as long as you are alive, your hair grows. Yes, your hair grows, but what causes it not to grow or what makes you believe that your hair don't grow is because of your maintenance, the way you maintain your hair. Yes, the way you maintain your hair goes a long way to determine whether your hair will grow or not. Yes, so I'll be sharing with you some of my experience while growing my natural hair and some mistakes which I have made in the past and which you can correct as a person. As you're listening to me, you will be able to tell yourself whether or not you have been doing most of these that I'm going to say. And when you stop doing most of them, you will see an instant growth in your hair. So I'll be diving into the 6 reasons why your hair don't grow. The first reason why your hair don't grow is that you play too much with your hair. Yes, I know as someone who is getting into natural hair, you tend to just imagine yourself styling your hair in different styles. You want to do this style, you want to do that style. Yes, that is normally what people do when they have natural hair. But let me tell you, you have to stop the hand syndrome, the hand touching hair syndrome. Yes, you have to stop doing that a lot because whenever you do that, you tend to break your hair. Yes, your hair tend to break anytime you, if you keep on touching it constantly, you play with it a lot, you style it and all of that. If you watch as you're styling it, your hairs are falling, your hairs are breaking. Especially, you know, as you're styling it, you have to comb them out. And the more you comb them out, the more your hair is breaking. So you have to stop. Why I was, when I started my hair journey, that is 5 years ago, I had to cut my relaxed hair. Yes, when I cut it, I realized I was looking different. So I had to start styling my hair just to look good and all of that. And I found out that my hair was not growing. Yes, that's because of the maintenance. I was breaking my hair because I was trying to style it to my liking. And so I was breaking my hair because I was trying to style it and all of that. So that breakage causes your hair, you will not see any growth because you are basically cutting off the ones that are growing out and then you're not seeing any growth at all. So that is one of the reasons why you should stop the hand syndrome touching of your hair. It really breaks your hair. That is reason number one. Another reason why you lose your hair, why your hair don't grow, is because of you're using the wrong tools. Yes, whenever you go into natural hair journey, you have to get the right tools. That is, you're using the right and proper tools to retain your hair length. Yes, so you're going into a natural hair journey, you need to get yourself a wide tooth comb. If you have been watching most of my video, I normally use this comb because if you're using a comb which has closer teeth, it tends to break and cut your hair. As you know that our natural hair is very delicate, so anything can break it. Most of the time, it's better off to use your fingers to detangle your hair, or you use a wide tooth comb to detangle your hair. No, don't make use of these rat tail combs. Yes, don't make use of them to comb your hair because the mouth or the teeth are quite close, very very close to each other. So as you're combing it out, your hair tend to break, so it breaks the length and all of that. So you want to get yourself white tooth comb, depending, there are ones that are even wider than this, depending on the one available to you, but make sure you get a white tooth comb. And also try as much as possible not to be combing most of the time. I normally like to use my fingers. I do most of finger detangling whenever I'm working with my hair, and it's not every time I make use of my white tooth comb. So try as much as possible to lessen the amount of time you comb your hair every time you have to work on your hair. So that is reason number two. Reason number three is that you have to trim your hair. Yes, you have to, every human being needs to be trimming their hair, because you might be thinking that whenever you trim your hair that you're losing hair. Yes, you might be losing hair, but what you gain back is going to be much more better than what you have lost. Yes, so for you to be able to go into this natural journey, you have to trim your hair at least once in a while. You have to trim your hair once in a while, because whenever you, if don't think because you have a coily hair you cannot trim your hair. Of course you can trim your hair, because whenever it grows back in a more better and more better structure and more better look. Yes, so you have to always trim your hair as much as possible. Reason number four is your hair needs moisture. Like if your hair is I can't stress it enough, because whenever your hair is lacking moisture, it tends not to grow. Yes, just as we human being cannot do without water, so as your hair cannot also do without water. When I mean moisture, I mean water. Your hair needs water internally and externally. Whenever you need to take enough water internally, and also don't forget to sprinkle water on your hair, especially once in a while, just to keep your hair moisturized. I don't mean using oil, because using oil does not do the work. You have to use natural pure water in order to moisturize your hair. Many of us do apply oil thinking that we are moisturizing our hair, but no, there is nothing good like applying water in your hair. Water is like a fertilizer. Yes, in as much as you tend not to see it as a fertilizer, but water is the main ingredient that grows your hair. Yes, whenever your hair is, just as whenever you plant a seed and it requires water to grow, so also does your hair requires water to grow. So you need to moisturize your hair once in a while. Make sure that your hair is not dry, make sure your hair is not lacking moisture, and also try to take enough water as much as possible so as to keep you hydrated from within and out. To drink enough water as much as possible, wash your hair and keep it moisturized. Wash it and keep it moisturized at least once in a week. And also make sure you apply leave-in conditioner just to help to retain that moisture there. Okay, so you should apply this in your natural hair regimen. Yes, the fifth reason why your hair is not growing is because of excessive heat. Whenever you're applying heat to your hair, this is a habit you need to stop. In as much as we feel beautiful whenever we stretch out our hair, but if you're going into a natural journey, you have to quit some certain habits, that is applying excessive heat to your hair, or even applying heat naturally, like blow drying your hair. Actually, whenever I wash my hair, I don't blow dry my hair. I allow my hair to dry naturally. Yes, because whenever you apply heat to your hair, it tends to dry out your hair. Your hair tends to dry out, and you wouldn't want that for your hair. And also, don't forget that initially I said your hair needs to be moisturized. So if you are trying to moisturize your hair at the same time applying heat to your hair, can you see you're not really achieving that aim of moisturizing your hair? You are draining out that moisture by using that heat. So you have to quit the habit of you applying heat on your hair. Yes, even as much as once in a while you can tend to stretch out your hair or blow out your hair, Yes, that is something you can do once in a while. Like, I have carried my hair for 5 years and I only stretched it only once. So, and I'm not sure I'm going to be doing that till further notice. So you try as much as possible to avoid heat on your hair, because heat is not good for your hair. This our hair is it acts as if it's living. Yes, so whenever you apply heat, you kill it. Yes, you kill it, and it tends to break again. It tends to break, and you wouldn't want that for your natural hair. So less heat application. No, every time straightening of hairs and all of that, blow drying once in a month. No, you don't need to blow dry your hair. You don't need to stretch your hair once in a month. You need to only stretch it at least once in a year. That's the highest I can recommend for anybody going into natural hair journey. Another reason why your hair don't grow is your diet. Yes. You need to keep your diet as clean as possible. Eat a lot of vegetable. Yes, avoid all those junk food, snacks and all of that. Once you're eating healthy, your hair will grow healthy. So avoid eating junk foods and all of that. Eat natural food, eat a lot of vegetables, and you'll see your hair will grow very, very well. So I have given you guys 6 tips on how to grow your hair. And growing of natural hair is not an easy journey. It is a lifetime journey which you have to devote your time and your patience. Yes, but I can assure you that if you follow these 6 tips which I have given, you will not regret it, and also you will see a difference in the way your hair grow. So you have to exercise patience whenever you're growing natural hair, because it deals with a lot of patience. And also make sure you follow these tips so in order to see results in your hair journey. So thank you very much. We have come to the end of this video. Do make sure you like, subscribe, click the notification bell so that anytime I upload, you will be the first to be notified. Thank you very much, and do have a lovely day. Bye.